Today, I'm going to show you how to use Apple Calendar like a pro. Have you ever scrambled to remember a meeting only to realize you missed it? You're not alone, but with a few quick tips, that'll be a thing of the past. And make sure to stick around until the end, and I'll show you how to download all these tips for free. So let's jump in. Let's take your organization skills up a notch by managing multiple calendars. Tap Calendars at the bottom of the screen, and you'll see a complete list of all the calendars on your phone, whether they're from Gmail, Yahoo, Apple, or even subscribed calendars like US Holidays or Siri Suggestions. Need to add a new calendar? It's simple. Tap Add Calendar in the bottom left. Here, you have a few options. You can add a regular calendar, subscribe to a calendar, or even add international holiday calendars, which can be particularly helpful if you work with teams abroad. Let's say you want to create a new work calendar. After tapping Add Calendar, you can name it Work, Personal, or whatever you like, and choose which account it should be associated with. To keep things visually clear, assign a unique color to your calendar. When you're done, just tap Done. I've set up separate calendars for work, family, and special projects. This way, I can easily toggle between them without mixing things up. The color coding is crucial here. It helps each calendar stand out when reviewing them all together, ensuring nothing gets lost in the shuffle. But let's not forget about collaboration. You can share individual iCloud calendars directly from the calendar app, but it's important to emphasize you can only share these Apple calendars. If, however, you want to share a calendar that's in another account, for instance, your Google Calendar or Yahoo Calendar, you'll need to log into that account in your web browser and share it in the settings there. You can get those specific instructions from your account provider. Now, to share an iCloud calendar, tap Calendars at the bottom, then tap the information button next to the calendar you want to share. Under Shared With, tap Add Person, and enter their name or email. You can even decide whether they can just view the calendar or have editing rights. Whether you're handling work deadlines, personal plans, or coordinating with others, Apple Calendar makes it easy to juggle everything. Let's look at how you can customize your calendar experience for quick access. One of the best ways to stay on top of your schedule without even unlocking your phone is by adding a calendar widget to your lock screen. This gives you instant access to your upcoming events at a glance. Here's how you do it. On your lock screen, press and hold until you see Customize. Then tap it, then Add Widgets. Scroll down to Calendar and select the widget you want and tap Add. Finally, tap Done to save your changes. I use this feature all the time. Just a quick glance at my lock screen and I know exactly what's coming up next. No need to open the application and no distractions. For more detailed information at your fingertips, consider adding calendar widgets to your home screen. These widgets come in various sizes and formats, so you can customize your view to match your needs. Setting it up is simple. Press and hold your home screen until the apps start to shake, tap the plus button in the top left corner, scroll down, and select Calendar. From there, choose the widget size and format that works best for you. Then tap Add Widget and place it on your home screen. I always keep a medium-sized widget on my home screen. It's perfect for getting a quick overview of my day without needing to open the application. And there's 6 calendar widgets to choose from. Sometimes plans change and you need to adjust your schedule on the fly. With Apple Calendar, you can quickly reschedule events, no need to open the event and manually change the details. Here's how you do it. Tap and hold the event you want to move, drag it to the new time slot or day, and release it to drop it into place. It's that easy. Need to adjust the duration? Just tap and hold the event, and you'll see 2 little circles above and below it. Drag these circles to adjust the length of the meeting to the time you prefer. No need to fumble with menus, just drag and drop, and you're set. To round out your mastery of Apple Calendar, let's explore how it integrates with other apps and devices. Apple Calendar isn't just a standalone app. It integrates seamlessly with other apps like iMessage, email, even Zoom. There is an enormous library of apps that integrate with the calendar. This cross-app integration is a powerful time saver, making sure you never miss an important event, no matter where the invitation comes from. Let's say you're texting somebody in Messages, and you agree to meet them for lunch on Friday at 1 p.m. Notice how the date and time are underlined? Just press and hold the underlined portion of the message, and the option to create an event pops up instantly. From there, you can configure all the settings we discussed earlier, location, travel time, calendar selection, and more, all without leaving your conversation. The same convenience applies to emails. Imagine receiving an email about an upcoming event like this one I have here for Riverfest near my home. Simply press and hold the date in the email, then select Create Event, and all the relevant details are added to your calendar with just a few taps. No need to jump back and forth between apps to copy and paste information. Now, let's take it a step further with Reminders integration. This is perfect if you have specific tasks you need to complete in preparation for a big meeting or other event. It's as simple as dragging and dropping. Press and hold the event in your calendar, drag it over to the Reminders app, and drop it onto a list. A new reminder is automatically created, and from there, you can add any additional details you need. You'll notice that this reminder looks different from our other reminders with this little calendar. If you tap the calendar, it opens up the event in the calendar with all the supporting details. I use this integration all the time to make sure I'm prepared and tracking deliverables tied to a deadline. It helps me keep everything aligned and on schedule. One of the biggest advantages of being in the Apple ecosystem is continuity. When you add an event on your iPhone, it automatically syncs across all your Apple devices, your iPad, your Mac, and even your Apple Watch, all without any extra steps. Now, let's talk about a feature that's sometimes overlooked and very powerful, attaching files and notes directly to your calendar events. This allows us to keep important details or files at our fingertips and share them with other attendees. Most people know how to attach files when they're on a computer, but it's a little different on your iPhone. If your attachment is stored in iCloud, it's simple. Just tap Add Attachment, navigate through your files, and select the one you need. But what if the file isn't in your Files app? No problem. Let's say the file is in Photos instead. Swipe up to close the calendar, find the photo, tap and hold to grab it, and then swipe back to the calendar app with your free hand and drop it into the attachment field. The same drag and drop method works for attachments from the Notes app, email, or tasks from Reminders. Similarly, you can add notes directly to the event details. Type them in, copy and paste from another app, or drag and drop just like with attachments. This is perfect for keeping meeting agendas, past discussions, or other crucial information organized. Let's quickly get familiar with Apple Calendar's navigation. We'll glide through the day, weekly, monthly, and yearly views to see how they all connect to keep your schedule in check without overwhelming you. First up is the day view, my go-to for managing the details of each day. This is where you get into the nitty-gritty of your schedule, focusing on what's immediately ahead. At the top, you can select individual days within the current week, but you can also swipe left or right to move exactly 1 week at a time. This makes it easy to look ahead or review what's just passed. Use the day view to find pockets of free time or to manage a jam-packed day with ease. And if you ever feel lost, just tap today to snap back to the present. Now let's zoom out a bit to the weekly view. This is where you get a clean snapshot of your entire week at a glance. Just turn your phone sideways and the week view automatically appears, laying out all your events in chronological order. It's perfect for spotting gaps, balancing busy days, and making sure nothing slips through the cracks. I find this view particularly useful for managing work deadlines and personal appointments. It's a quick way to see where you might need to move things around or where you have room for new tasks. At the start of each week, just spend a few minutes here to get your week in order. Next, for a broader perspective, let's shift to the monthly view. This view gives you a high-level overview of your entire month. Just tap on the month in the corner, and you can easily scroll through past and future months to find the day you're interested in. You'll notice that today's date is circled in red, and any days that have events already scheduled have gray dots. While these dots don't provide any detail on their own, tapping this icon at the top reveals a list of all your appointments for the selected day. When you're done, just tap the icon again to return to the month view. Finally, let's zoom out to the yearly view. Honestly, there's not a lot of value here. It's helpful to move through different years, but that's about it. What's great about Apple Calendar is how these all work together. You can easily move from the detailed day view to the broader weekly or monthly views with just a few taps and swipes. It's all about staying in control no matter how packed your schedule gets. With your calendars organized, let's discuss all the options we have for creating and configuring events on the calendar. My favorite way to add an event is by simply tapping and holding the time slot on the calendar itself. A new event window pops up with the time already set. From there, just enter your event title. You can manually type a location, or even better, start typing a business name or address, and Apple will suggest locations for you. Once you've chosen a location, you can actually set a travel time so your phone will estimate how long it will take you to get there, whether you're walking, driving, or biking. This is especially handy for meetings outside the office. Next, select the calendar that this event belongs to, for instance, work or family, and invite anyone who needs to be there. If it's a recurring event, set it up as daily, weekly, monthly, or even a custom frequency. This is a huge time saver for regularly scheduled meetings. Alternatively, you can tap the plus button in the top right corner, enter the details as you did before, and all the same options are available. It's a straightforward method for those who prefer a more traditional approach. Next up, let's talk about alerts. You'll never miss an important event again with customizable alerts on the calendar app. This feature makes sure you're reminded exactly when you need to be, whether it's minutes, hours, or days in advance. To set an alert, tap on the event, then tap Edit in the top right corner, scroll to Alert, and choose when you'd like to be reminded. For important events, I always set multiple alerts, one for the day before to make sure any prep work is completed, and another just before it starts. You can also add an alert based on travel time. Set it to remind you when it's time to leave, factoring in the estimated travel time you set earlier. It's perfect for making sure you're never late. And that's it. Whether you're managing day-to-day tasks, coordinating multiple calendars, or leveraging advanced features, this app is versatile enough to meet all your planning needs. If you'd like to download a copy of all these tips for free, just click the link in the video description below. If you found this guide helpful, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more tech tips. I'll see you in the next video.